Hello children, so today we are going to revise grammar. Let's see, this is the portion for our S7 online exam. This chapter's articles, adjectives, degrees of comparison, verbs and sentences. This is the portion for S7 online exam. Now let's start our revision. You have to click on the correct option, children. Always remember, while solving the online exam, you have to read the questions carefully, give attention to the given options, think about the options, think about the correct answer, and then click on the correct answer. Okay. So no need to make hurry, no need to get excited, although you find any question very easy. Still, you have to go very slow, read it again and then click. Because once you have clicked, you cannot undo it, isn't it? So remember this thing. The first sentence is, Sheila is dash honest girl. Options given are an, a and the. Sheila is dash honest girl. So this sentence is from our article lesson. Okay. So which article will come here? Sheila is dash honest girl. Will it be an? Sheila is an honest girl. Sheila is a honest girl. Or Sheila is the honest girl. And the answer will be option A, an honest girl. Why? Because after the blank, the word that is starting with vowel sound, O. Okay. So, and we have studied that article an is used before the word that starts with the vowel sound. So, we have put a tick mark on option A, an. Sheila is an honest girl. Second question. He was sent to dash. A prison, prison or the prison? He was sent to a prison, prison or the prison? Option C is the correct answer. He was sent to the prison. Because we know the particular place. So we have given option the prison. Third question. Innocent people were killed in the bomb blast. And the instruction given in the bracket is, identify the kind of adjective. The word which is underlined, that is an adjective in the sentence, and you have to identify the kind of that adjective. Now, adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, and possessive adjective. These three options are given. Which will be the correct answer? Is it an adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, or possessive adjective, adjective of possession? The correct answer is adjective of quality. We have learned that, children, the word which qualifies the noun in the sentence. And which is the noun in this sentence? It is people. And the word innocent is qualifying the noun people. So, innocent is an adjective of quality. Fourth question. Dash book is this. Click on the correct adjective. Which adjective will be best suited here? Dash book is this. What book is this? Whose book is this? Or when book is this? And the correct answer is option B, whose. Whose book is this? Fifth question. Comparative degree of thin is. This question is from degrees of comparison. You remember, children, we have studied three degrees of comparison. Positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. So, comparative degree of thin is what? Is it THINER, thiner, THRNNER, thinner, or THENER, thinner? which will be the correct answer? It's option B, thinner, thinner. Okay, thinner, thinner is the correct answer. Then let's move to sixth question. My bag is dash than yours, heavy. Now we have to make use of correct degree of comparison. Of course, by seeing the sentence, we understood that the which kind of degree of comparison will come here. Here the bag is compared with whom? With my bag, with and your bag. So option A, more heavy will come, heavier will come, or most heavy. Option C will not at all be there because it's superlative degree, and here any comparative degree word will come. So more heavy or heavier will come. Option B is the correct answer, children. H-E-A-V-I-E-R, heavier. My bag is heavier than yours. You remember, while studying degrees of comparison, we have seen this point that if the word is ending with Y, we have to change the last letter Y into I, and then we can change it into comparative and superlative by adding ER and EST. Isn't it? So H-E-A-V-Y, this word is ending with Y. So we changed Y into I and added ER to make it comparative. So option B is the correct answer. Seventh question. I wrote a letter to my father. Identify the action verb. Now read the sentence aloud and identify the action verb. Which word is showing you the action? I wrote a letter to my father. Is it option A, I, option B, wrote, or option C, father? So quickly you answer, children. You are correct. Option B is the correct answer, wrote, because it's an action verb. Of course, I will not come there. I is not at all action verb. It's a pronoun. And then father is a noun. This much we understood now, isn't it? So I wrote a letter to my father. Wrote is the action verb. Question 8. Past tense of go is gone, went, or will go. Option B is the correct answer, went. Past tense of go is went. Gone is the past participle of go. Go, went, gone. And will go, of course, it is in future tense. And we are asked here the past tense of go, that is went. Now ninth, an exclamatory sentence always ends with a full stop. An exclamatory sentence always ends with a full stop. Is it true or false? In the course lesson sentences, we have studied different types of sentences. Isn't it? Declarative sentence, assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and exclamatory sentence. So, an exclamatory sentence always ends with a full stop. What do you think? Is it true or false? You remember, exclamatory sentences express strong feelings or emotions. And we have studied that they begin with a capital letter and end with an exclamation mark. They don't end with a full stop. So this is a false sentence. So we will click on B option, false. 10th question, open the door. Identify the kind of sentence. Which kind of sentence it is? Open the door. Is it interrogative, imperative, or exclamatory? Just now I revised what are the exclamatory sentences. And interrogative sentences, very easy to remember the sentences which ask a question. Is this sentence asking a question? No. Then it will be an imperative sentence, because imperative sentences express an order, a request, or an advice. So this type of sentences are imperative sentence, that is what we have studied. So this way we have come to an end of today's revision of grammar. Go through the topics again and again, solve the exercises and practice more, children. And as I told you in the beginning of the lesson, in the beginning of the revision, don't be in hurry. Don't get excited when you sit to solve the SA1 online exam. Keep yourself calm, quiet. Go through each and every question carefully. Read all the options. Think. And once you are confident, then only click on the correct option. And don't forget to press submit button at the end of the exam. Okay? I wish all of you best of luck. Thank you, Sai Ram.